Hello everyone out there on the internet, it's me, John, back again with another review, and today we're in the second of a series of instant ramen reviews, and this is the premium 7-Eleven brand, along with Nissin, who creates instant ramen that you've probably had before, but this is only available in Japan in the 7-Eleven stores in Japan. Now, each one of these ramens are a collaboration between 7-Eleven, Nissin Brands, and some ramen restaurant in Japan. Today's ramen comes from a company called, I think it's pronounced Sumire. And Sumire is a Sapporo, I think it's called Sapporo style, instant ramen, or just ramen in general, which is typically a more yellow curly noodle. And Sumire actually comes from a word that in the Japanese letters could be read both as Sumire and another word that means miso, I think. I might be wrong on this. I just did a quick Google about this place to make sure I knew at least something about it. But they are most famous for their miso variety. And that's exactly what we have here for the 7-Eleven variety. So I've already put the noodles and the dry ingredients in the bowl with boiling water for 4 minutes. Now I'm just simply going to remove the lid. Mix it up and add the other ingredients to it. Here is the label. You can see there's a three Japanese letters here. And it seems, for the most part, a lot of the ramen places that I've seen, it's like three symbols is like the name of their store, typically. So I'm just gonna break up the noodles. As you can see, they are yellow. And they are curly. The dry ingredients that were in here were green onion, some bamboo shoots. Let's see if I can get one of those. Bamboo is known as menma, I think is the Japanese term. And there's also little chunks of ground beef in there as well. So now I'm going to add the seasoning packets. I'm going to add the dry one first, as it says here. I should have kind of pre-opened this one. That wasn't too hard. So this powder should be a miso powder. I think it also has both chicken and pork in the ingredients, so it is not for the vegetarians, if you didn't know about the meat that was in it anyway. There. That should be a lot easier now. The powder tastes pretty good. Mix that in. And then the last packet is oil. And I had these packets sitting on top while it was heating up, so the oil is actually kind of warm itself. One thing that I saw online when I looked at some like reviews of the actual restaurant, and they do actually like put a ladle of hot oil on top of the bowl of ramen. And they say that is, well, there's more than oil in here, there's like a paste, that is supposed to keep the broth hotter for longer. Not sure if that's true, but I've seen that in a couple different reviews. This is a little packet that had the vegetables in there. So now that's like a little bit of oil, a little bit of paste. I'm gonna mix that in. getting nice and creamy. I'm gonna give you a look over the top once I get this mixed up. So the other one had more impressive toppings. This one's not gonna look as impressive. You can see some green onion there. You can see some of the bamboo, and you can see some of the ground beef. Now let's go ahead and have a taste. It's pleasant. Much lighter than the tonkatsu that I had last week. The noodles are chewy. They don't have like a clean bite to them. Just kind of give them a nice chew before you can swallow some of that bamboo. Bamboo really kept its like crunch to it. Try a little bit, piece of this meat. It's pleasant. Not gristly at all. Really absorbed the flavor and the broth very well. Let me see if I can get one of these pieces of green onion. Okay, not bad. You know, some fresh green onion on top of here would be a really good idea. And I do have some, but I just wanted this to be a review of everything that comes in it by itself. Because not everyone will always have something to put in there. Alright, now let's get a couple spoons of the straight up broth. Not overly salty. So if you like a shio, if you're a fan of the salty shio type, this isn't not as salty as that. This is supposed to be like a golden miso. It doesn't really taste like the miso soups I've had before. But it's not bad. It's not as good as the tonkatsu what I had last week. I think it was Sakura was the restaurant. But again, tonkatsu is my favorite type of ramen. Whereas miso, I don't really get too often, and usually when I do, I'm just tasting someone else's. It's not bad, and if I were to go to a place like this in Japan that specializes in it, it'd be the bowl that I order. It's good. Again, the 7-Eleven Premium Bowl really brings it together with the add-ons. The oiliness of this is really rich, even though the flavor is light. And the anytime you get meat in an instant ramen, it's always a joy. It's not as good as the pork piece that was in the last one. But still a joy. Anyway, I'm going to enjoy the rest of this by myself in peace. This was the Sumire Instant Ramen. collaboration from Nissin Foods, 7-Eleven, and Sumire Sapporo Ramen. Anyway, hope you liked the video. Give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel. I got plenty of other ramen videos for you to watch that I've already done and coming up in the future, as well as some other stuff if you're interested. Anyway, I'll see you on the next one. Bye.